This is the behavioral characteristics and self-reported health status among 2,029 adults consuming a carnivore diet. It's a Harvard study on 2,029 adults consuming a carnivore diet. At average, the average of these people consuming the carnivore diet is over a period of 14 months. This is the study in its entirety. Now, I found a page that actually summarized all this data in a much neater way. So I'm going to use this page instead. I will link both of these pages in the description so you can read both if you want to. First, a huge disclaimer. Limitation of the study. As this is based on self-reported data, a potential limitation of this study is recall error and reporting bias. In addition, as this is an online survey, it is not possible to objectively assess the diet and its health outcomes. Now, what this means is the 2029 participants were basically just filling out web forms over a period of time and plotting down their own experiences, how they feel. There is no monitoring of the participants. They did not necessarily get followed up by doctors. Some may have, the study doesn't say. Anyways, so that's a huge disclaimer. Second disclaimer, I am on the carnivore diet and have been for 2 weeks because of this study, partly because of this study. It kind of made me want to try it. So anyways, we're gonna go over it. First, a little introduction. A survey on the carnivore diet experience of over 2,000 people was carried out in 2020 by a team of researchers from Harvard Medical School and other institutions. The survey findings were recently published on the 2nd of November in 2021 in Current Developments in Nutrition. In this post, we will look at the key findings of the study, including who participated in the survey, why they started the carnivore diet, how long they've been on the diet, what they ate, and what they experienced after switching to this diet. So first off, who conducted this study? Those people. Who participated in the study? Study participants were recruited from carnivore communities on Facebook, Instagram, Reddit, Twitter, and others between 30th of March to 24th of June 2020. Most of the participants were from the US, Canada, Europe, and Australia. Two-thirds of the participants were male, and the remaining were female and other. The participant age was from 18 to 85. Their average was 44. Their weight ranged from 38 kilos to 176 kilos. And their average weight was 76 kilos. Nearly two-thirds of the participants had a tertiary education. Is basically just higher educations like universities and colleges, trade schools. Okay, get it. Their income status was spread out between 20% reporting high income, 66% middle, and 14% low. Now, why did they start the carnivore diet? 93% of the participants stated that the main reason for starting the carnivore diet was health and weight loss. Within health reasons, their motivations were further broken down as follows. Weight, body composition, focus and energy, allergy, skin, and autoimmunity, digestive health, athletic performance, mental health, and diabetes. How long have they been on the carnivore diet? The participant included in the study reported having been on the carnivore diet for 6 months to 337 months, or 28 years. I am guessing there is one person in this study that was doing the carnivore diet for 28 years. But anyways, it counts. The average reported was 14 months. What did they eat on the carnivore diet? The carnivore diet suggests you should be eating meat, fish, and animal products. So I'm guessing that's what they ate, but let's go over it. Ruminant meat, meaning beef, lamb, goat, venison, stuff like that. That was the most commonly consumed food. Eggs were the next popular food on the participants. Non-dairy milk was also popular, like cream and cheese. Milk was consumed weekly or more frequently by only 17%, so not a lot. Pork and poultry was less popular. 13% reported consuming pork at least once a day. 53% had pork one to a few times a week. 2.5% reported consuming poultry at least once a day, and 38% had poultry weekly, so not as often as the other. Fish was consumed daily by 3.5% and weekly by 36%. So a good amount of people actually had fish in their diet. That's good. Organ meat was consumed at least once a week by 42% of the participants. Bone broth was consumed monthly or more frequently by 52% of the participants. Condiments were rarely used, with only 1.7% reported using at least daily and 53% with no use. Herbs and spices were more commonly used at least daily by 21% of the participants. Salt was consumed liberally by 36% of the participants. The rest reported low to medium salt intake or no specific target. What were their preferred meat choices and how did they have it prepared? Their meat choices were as follows. 61% chose high fats, 37% chose a moderate fat, and 2% chose lean. With regards to meat quality, 46% chose 100% grass-finished or predominantly grass-finished. 54% chose grain-finished or predominantly grain-finished. Their preferred way of preparing it was as follows. 2% liked it raw, 29% liked it rare, 45% liked it medium-rare, 15% liked it medium, and 6% liked it well done, medium to well done. What did they drink on the carnivore diet? Coffee was a popular drink for this group, carnivore dieters, with 57% reported drinking coffee at least daily. 24% reported never drinking coffee. Tea was less popular. Alcohol was rarely consumed. And electrolyte supplements were used daily by 17% of the participants, while 24 used them a few times a year to a few times a week. And 59% didn't use electrolytes at all. How often did they eat? Most participants had only 1 to 2 meals a day. 64% ate 2 times a day. 17% ate 1 time a day. 17% ate 3 times. And 2% ate less. Now over to the interesting stuff. What did they experience on the carnivore diet? Overall, the authors of the study found that, contrary to common expectations, adults consuming a carnivore diet experience few adverse effects and instead reported health benefits and high satisfaction. 1. Self-reported change in health status. An overwhelmingly majority of the participants experienced positive outcomes. Now, you can read those for yourself. But there was a lot of improvements to their health, according to themselves. 2. Changes in chronic conditions and medication usage. Again, an overwhelmingly majority of the participants reported improvements in chronic conditions and reductions in medication usage. Now, in particular, you can see here on the screen, but what I find interesting is that overweight people and obese people improved or resolved their issues by going on a carnivore diet. 93% said that by going on this carnivore diet, their overweight and obesity issues was either improved or resolved. In relation to diabetes and medication, 100%, meaning every single participant who used diabetes injectables in this study stopped using it. 92% discontinued insulin for type 2 diabetes altogether. 90% discontinued or decreased insulin. 84% discontinued oral diabetes medication. So if you have diabetes, according to these 2,029 people, it does seem like this is a way to go, something to try. If you've tried everything, I mean, speak with your doctor. Other than that, I've seen meat and vegetables being suggested by doctors for diabetes. So this is basically the same, just without the vegetables. While bearing in mind that these are self-reported results, there is no drug that I know of that has had a such spectacular health outcome as the carnivore diet. The participants of the survey also reported a high level of satisfaction with the carnivore diet, with 98% being either very satisfied or satisfied. The majority of the participants reported that being on the diet did not impact their social life, and that their medical providers and family and friends were mostly neutral or supportive of their dietary choice. To end this out, we're going to go over the conclusion of the study. While the findings of this study are probably what the carnivore community would have already known or expected, I think it is significant that as a team of researchers from well-respected institutions have actually looked into it. I think it is a signal that the carnivore diet is becoming a mainstream diet, and we can expect a lot more research into this diet in the near future. And hopefully, many more people will try out and benefit from this way of eating. I also hope that in the future, the carnivore diet will become the first line of recommendations for people who suffer from chronic diseases and that are currently labeled as incurable by medical professionals. This is exactly what the ICMNI in Hungary is doing at the moment. International Center for Medical Nutrition and Intervention. This is exactly what the ICMNI does in Hungary, treating many chronic diseases with a high-fat animal-based diet. And the article itself has its own disclaimer. Now, the information in this post is for reference purpose only and not intended to constitute or replace professional medical advice. Please conduct a qualified medical professional before making any changes to your diet or lifestyle. Okay, so that's a good disclaimer to have. To sum it up, this is the article and this is the study that kind of made me want to try the carnivore diet. Now, I've only been on it for 2 weeks, so I haven't really gotten that many results, but I'll make a different video with me going over my own experiences and how the 2 weeks have been for me. Okay, I'm ending it here. I try and test stuff on the internet, and in this round, I am going for the carnivore diet. Thank you for watching.